Welcome to Developing with DocuSign. I'm Carissa Jacobson, a member of the Developer Center team. In this screencast, I'll walk through installing and running the Python Quick Start on a Mac and the embedded signing code example. To follow along in this demo, you'll first need to download a Quick Start configured for Python. If you haven't yet downloaded your Python Quick Start, please first follow the steps in the Quick Start overview page or the How to Download Quick Start video. Quick Start is a software wizard that packages a personalized code example launcher. You can choose from 8 programming languages. The Quick Start wizard configures an app in the developer's DocuSign account that can make API calls. These steps are completed for the developer. The launcher is downloaded from GitHub as a zip file, an integration key is created in the developer's account, a secret key is created to enable authorization code grant, an RSA key pair is created to enable JWT grant, redirection URLs are added, and the configuration file is modified with the developer's personalized information. You can find all the prerequisites for the Python Quick Start in the README on our GitHub page at github.com/docusign/code-examples-python. This README is also included in the Quick Start zip file. The README has a description of all of our API code examples with their source links to GitHub. In the installation prerequisites section, it says, note, if you downloaded this code using Quick Start from the DocuSign Developer Center, skip steps 1 and 2 below as they're automatically performed for you. The Python prerequisite is step 3, because Quick Start takes care of step 4 by pre-populating my developer account information, which I'll show later. To install and run the Python launcher, I'll need Python 3. In the installation steps in the README, it says, note, if you downloaded this code using Quick Start from the DocuSign Developer Center, skip steps 4 and 5 below, as they're automatically performed for you. Next, it says 1, extract the Quick Start zip file or download or clone the code examples Python repository. The Quick Start automatically downloads into my downloads folder. I'll extract my Quick Start zip file into my source folder. Here in my extracted Quick Start folder, you can see that the Quick Start wizard appends a dash and the code language on the end of my Quick Start folder name. Quick Start enables developers to quickly run DocuSign code examples by configuring a launcher with the developer's account information. For the Python Quick Start, this configuration file is located in the app folder and is named ds_config.py. Aside from my email address and name, my unique client ID, client secret, and impersonated user GUID are also displayed in the configuration file. In my DocuSign developer account, OAuth elements have DocuSign names. I can find these OAuth elements on the Apps and Keys page. My DS impersonated user ID is called the API username and is located under my account information. Also, my DS client ID is called the integration key and can be found under Apps and Integration Keys next to my app name Tally Customer Portal. In addition, my DS client secret is called a secret key and can be found by selecting the Actions button next to my app name, then choosing Edit. The secret key is located under Authentication. If I forget my secret key, I can create a new one by selecting Add Secret Key and pasting it in my dsconfig.py file. Since the dsconfig.py file contains personal information such as your name, email address, impersonated user ID, client ID, and client secret, please don't store in your source control. I can also view and modify the source files in my Quick Start folder and see my changes when running that code example. The Python Quick Start launcher will directly open the embedded signing code example page, which I'll show later. Here's the code for embedded signing. All examples in this Quick Start are in their own folder with a controller and view file. I've opened the controller file, which defines the methods used by this example. On line 96, I'll change the name of the DocuSign document from example document to Hello World and save my changes. This name will be shown when the document is presented in the browser. Moving on to step 2 from the README, which says 2. Switch to the folder CD Quick Start folder name. I'll use Terminal to navigate to my extracted Quick Start folder, Tally Customer Portal-Python. Next, I'll install all dependencies using step 3, pip3 install-r requirements.txt. Now I can run the Python launcher using step 6, Python 3 run.py, and view the application with step 7, open a browser to localhost on port 5000. The Quick Start will automatically attempt to authorize the user using the authorization code grant flow when first run. I see the consent window from the application Tally Customer Portal. This consent window grants the app permission to perform actions on behalf of the user within the signature scope. This is required to call most eSignature API endpoints and so is needed for the first of our code examples, embedded signing. All Quick Starts are set up to run this example when they first launch. When the user clicks Accept to grant that permission, DocuSign gives the app an authorization code that can be exchanged for an OAuth access token, which DocuSign requires you to include in your API calls. QuickStart also adds a private.key file and configures my dsconfig.py file for JSON Web Token, or JWT grant, so I could select that flow after completing embedded signing. Once the user has granted consent to an application, they will not be prompted again for actions under the specified scope unless consent is revoked. Now that I've authorized the app and it's gotten its access token, I see the embedded signing code example. Embedded signing demonstrates how to collect signatures directly within my app without emailing the signer. Also linked are the API methods used, envelopes create and envelope views create recipient. The links will take me to the Developer Center pages that describe those methods. The link to the source file will show me the Python code for the embedded signing in GitHub. The signer email and name have been pre-populated with my developer account information, but I could choose to change those values. Once I click Submit to send the envelope, I'm taken directly to the document. Now I'll scroll to the bottom of the document and see that the document name is no longer example document, but has been changed to Hello World, just as I changed it to be. I'll sign the document and click Finish. I'm then taken to the signing complete page. I'll click Continue. Now I see the Python Launcher homepage with all the code examples. I can run the other code examples as well. All these code examples are also available in the other QuickStart launchers: Bash, C#, Java, Node.js, PHP, PowerShell, and Ruby. If you have any questions about how to develop your integration with DocuSign, here are some resources. I recommend checking out the Developer Center how-to guides, going to Stack Overflow, reaching out to support, or signing up for API office hours. That's it. Thanks for tuning in. If you're watching from our YouTube channel, please post questions and comments below the video or email us at developers@docusign.com.